Some people ask us, what are the pros and cons of signing up for cryopreservation? Or more precisely, what are the pros and cons of being cryopreserved at the end of your life? Now, let's start with the pros. I think the main pro, and I'm pretty sure everybody agrees, is that cryopreservation gives you the chance, and it's very important to state, this is just a chance. It's by no means a guarantee that at some point in the potentially far future, hopefully not super far, but might be far, it is possible to bring you back from cryopreservation. So cryopreservation, of course, is only always done at the time when a person dies and when the alternative, at least in most countries, would be either cremation or burial. So people can practically decide, do you want to be buried or cremated, or do you want to be cryopreserved? Now, as far as I'm concerned, cryopreservation gives you a significantly higher chance of being around in the future than cremation or burial. I can't really say how long it will take or what the chance of being around in the future will be, but I'm very, very confident to say the chance is higher, at the very minimum, than cremation or burial. Now, why do you want to be around in the future? So why is it even a pro? Well, I would argue for everybody who likes life, right? And I do very much, and most people who sign up for cryopreservation do. Cryopreservation gives you potentially more time to enjoy that life. And in addition to that, it gives you the opportunity, again, potentially, to, you know, see the future, see how society will have developed, right? What will be possible technologically? And just think back, if you go, you know, just 100 years back, stuff that we do today, you know, basically every day, using a mobile, calling another continent, and so on, would be almost unheard of just 100 years ago. And then if you go 200 years ago, a lot of the stuff, what we do today, would be very much akin to magic to a person from that age. So on the pro side, I think this is the main thing, gives you the chance to potentially live again in the future after being cryopreserved. Once a lot of medical issues that, you know, plague people right now, be it cancer, be it, you know, heart disease, and whatever you name it, will be solved. And at that point, it would probably also be possible to rejuvenate a body. So of course it doesn't make sense to be cryopreserved as an 85-year-old, and then, you know, when you're being brought back potentially, let's say in 100 years from now, you kind of live with a low quality of life some 85-year-olds might have. No, the idea would of course be that you live with, you know, full physical and mental fitness, and just have more time to enjoy life and experience however the future might look. So that's the pro side. On the con side, I think there are two main things to consider. First of all, and I already said it multiple times in this video, it is not clear if and when cryopreservation works. So arguably, it is pretty much a gamble that you take, well, at the end of the life, when arguably the other two options are worse. But of course, cryopreservation, at least today, is relatively expensive. So whole body cryopreservation with us, for example, and similar-ish to other organizations around the world, is in the vicinity of 200,000 euros. So pretty expensive. So the buying something or signing up for something or for 200,000 euros, even though, of course, you only need to pay this at the time of death, is arguably a downside, because you might have, you know, other stuff that you want to do with the money, you know, give it to your children or donate to some other cause that is important to you. So I think the consideration on the con side would be, how much do you value the chance that you would be around in the future? How much do you value that against other things that you care about? And if you feel like, you know, 200,000 euros is, you know, worth it in quotation marks, then I think this con might not necessarily be too much of an issue for you. But for a lot of people, they care about multiple things. And 200,000 euros is unfortunately a relatively large amount of money. I said it multiple times again already in other videos that this is one of the main pet peeves I have with the current cryopreservation field. The fact that 200,000 euros is prohibitively expensive for a lot of people. So we're very much working on reducing the cost and reducing that con. But so far, of course, it is. The second con arguably is that it's not clear in what kind of future you would wake up. I think the likelihood that you would wake up in some type of a dystopian future that you might know from some science fiction movies, the probability of that, I think, is pretty low. And the reason for that is most dystopian futures, I don't see any, you know, good logical arguments why they would need, you know, one more human from the far, far past. There's probably a significantly easier ways to solve a lot of problems that they might have than bringing someone back, which might be quite resource intensive process. So I think there's a higher chance that you would wake up in something that is akin to a utopian future, at least as good or as utopian as it would be in right now, right? So I don't think it's going to be worse. It's going to be probably better. But nevertheless, there might be some downsides, not the least of which would be that, you know, let's say it's 100 years in the future or 200 years in the future, society, how stuff works, how technology works, even how social interactions work might have changed to a degree, and they probably will change to a degree. You might wake up in a future where you need a good amount of time to get used to that future again. So arguably, I would say that's probably a con. It's not a con that we can do much about, apart from part of the organization that is tasked with making sure that you're being kept in cryopreservation and then being woken up once possible. So the foundation side of the whole cryopreservation organizational structure, that organization is of course partly thinking about what would need to be set in place to make sure this transition from, you know, into the future, kind of getting accustomed to, you know, how society works, what technology is now available, and so on and so on. That organization would take part of it, take responsibility for it, and we set this up so that this organization would already start thinking about it much earlier than actually a revival would be possible. On the pro side, you might be around in the future. You might be able to experience life significantly longer than medically possible right now. You might see the future. Future might be very exciting, and of course, I believe it will be. On the con side would be it's relatively expensive. It's not clear if it works, right? It's possible that these 200,000 euros would be, in quotation marks, thrown out of the window. And you might wake up in future society that needs at least a good amount of getting used to it and so on. There are sometimes some more, you know, esoteric downsides being discussed about really like dystopian futures and so on and so on. I think all of those, you know, very, very downside, very negative scenarios, I think they're extremely unlikely. So I think these are the main pros and cons that if you consider signing up for cryopreservations are the ones that you should consider. By the way, if you want to learn more about how revival from cryopreservation might work, check out the video here. And if you want to discuss this or any other topic with us, feel free to reach out at any point, leave a comment below, or go to tomorrow.bio, schedule a consultation with us, or write us an email. We're more than happy to answer all your questions and help you make an informed decision about cryopreservation.